to help us investigate Big Brother's latest cops and robbers task. We've brought back our favourite criminal mastermind. It's Crime Watch's Mr. Rev Warning, everybody!
Rev, how are you?
Very well, thank you, sir.
Guys, don't you feel a lot safer now Rev's here?
Yeah.
First off, I want to ask you, Big Brother's just caught him red-handed in the house doing this code-talking thing. Obviously, big crime. What do you think would be a kind of, you know, suitable punishment?
Well, I don't know, but we've seen that Big Brother's not messing about this year. Yep. So something big is going to come down. I think they might do the old school teacher trick and punish the lot of them.
Really?
Yeah.
Do you think that would work, guys? Do you think? Because when they're trying to single people out, they don't, nobody kind of takes heed, do they?
No, they're not listening. It's
now,
obviously not working.
The big news that we just broke. It turns out Stu has just been stripped for his role head of house. Look at him. Now we're going to show you a little clip of him in the diary room singing like a canary, basically. Yeah. Let's have a look.
So I'm not planning on giving up my place in heaven lightly, which I hope is a competition on Saturday, and it's not someone has to choose who goes to heaven, because that's rubbish. I want it to be a competition, and whatever it is, I will do anything to win.
Desperate to stay in there, isn't he?
Desperate, he is desperate. Is that a guilty conscience, though? Is he? Has he done something really bad that he's trying to cover up and plead with Big Brother to look after him?
Maybe. Maybe. Do you think there's someone? Who do you think's kind of running all of this? Obviously, someone must have initiated the code. I don't think it's Stuart. Who do you think it might be in there?
Well, we've all seen Luke's a little bit of a snitch, a little mow the grass, but Darnell's been a bit cheeky recently.
Really?
Yeah, I think he could be part of this.
Should we have a little look and see if there's been any shifty housemates? Let's have a look at them now. Rav, I need you to, you know, delve deep in there. What's your gut instinct? What's your reaction saying? This man knows the criminal underworld inside out. Bear that in mind, everybody.
Well, I've got to say, 8 years as a detective, that's thrown it wide open for
me.
Wow. Could be any of them.
Yeah, look at that moustache. That would throw it wide open for me. Now, of course, this week's task, all about cops and robbers. There's four parts of the task. Rav, would you mind helping us through them all? All right, let's go over here, guys. Now, as you can see, just reeks of criminal activity over here. First up, Rav, we've got safe cracking. What kind of people usually get involved in safe cracking?
Well, they tend to be the painstakingly slow, meticulous criminals, not the ones that go blurting out, you know, what
they're
getting
up to. Okay, they're not the big flash guys.
No, not flash Harry, these
somebody
ones.
Somebody who's quite quiet, somebody who's quite pensive, perhaps.
Exactly that. So perhaps May soon.
May soon, what do we reckon? Yeah, you think she'd be suitable, guys?
Yeah.
Is she any good at numbers, though? That's the big question.
Well, that is the question. But maybe a couple of them could help around.
Okay, do you think they're going to do all right on that?
This one, I think they're going to be all right.
Okay, let's move on to the next one. We're going to talk. It's a big pile of cash here. Okay, this is all to do with counterfeiting. You must have met some undesirable counterfeiters in your time.
Yeah, there is thousands and thousands and thousands of counterfeit money all over the UK. I've met quite a few of them. Most of them tend to be a little bit stupid, to be honest.
Really? Okay.
Yeah. So I think Dale could be quite good at this one.
Yeah. And what exactly have they got to do? They've just got to
make up their own money. They've got to stamp it. They've got to ink it. They've got to chop it up. And then they've got to hang it up to dry. They're trying to make 100 grand. We've all seen Dale would do anything to get 100 grand.
Yes, clearly.
So I think they're going to be all right.
I'm sure he'll be doing it topless, that's for sure. and then next up, we've actually got, what have we got? Oh, it's the identity parade.
Yeah.
And this is where six people are going to, here we go, right? They're going to be taken into the house. And it's going to be inside that they've got Nazza, who's Mohammed's brother, and Rex's girlfriend, Nicole, alongside four actors. They've got to correctly identify Nazza and Rex's girlfriend. How difficult is that going to be?
Well, identity parades are the hardest part of investigation. Yeah. They are going to be extremely hard to do in any walk of life, let alone inside the Big Brother house. Okay. So I think they're going to find this one pretty tough.
And I mean, you know, are there any tricks that cons, you know, use to avoid getting picked out?
It's funny you say that. A lot of the cons do tend to look away when they're feeling a little bit like they're under pressure.
Okay.
So our stooges in there, if they're looking away, they could be the
guilty
parties.
They're going to get
caught out. The housemates should be looking out for little tricks.
Okay.
Like that.
Do you think they're going to pass this one?
It's going to be tough, but I think 50-50 that one.
50-50 on this one. 50-50. Okay. And then we're going to the old classic, the American Stakeout. Two housemates constantly got to be on shift in the BBPD police car for 24 hours. They're going to be fed burgers, donuts and coffee to enjoy throughout the shift. This is going to take place in the garden. All the heavenly housemates have got to take part. I've got to ask you, have you ever been on a steakhouse?
Yeah, I've been on a few steakhouse.
What are they like?
They are not very glamorous, I'm afraid.
Coffee, donuts?
More like weeing in a bottle and hiding amongst rats and mice. Yeah, not very nice, I'm afraid.
Let's take a moment. Let's just get a visual picture of that now. That's lovely. In the movies, they seem very boring.
Yeah, they're probably slightly more boring than you see in the movies.
Okay,
yeah.
And what happened? I mean, surely, like, there must have been. I mean, did you ever drop off at the choice moment?
It's very, very tempting to go to sleep. So Rex is going to struggle.
Okay.
You've got to keep yourself awake.
Rex, no good for this one. Do you think they're going to get through this task?
I think they're probably going to be all right. I mean, let's have a look who we've got in there. We've got four heavenly housemates. We've got Rex, he's just going to sleep. Mohammed's going to think it's Christmas because of all the food.
Absolutely.
We've got Mikey. Well, we probably won't go there with Mikey. Who have we got? Les Stewart. He's the only one that I think is going to...
Okay, you think Stuart's going to be good at that? Now, I'm going to make a lot of ladies' dreams come true now, Rav. Obviously, we only really saw you since you've changed profession. But we're going to take you back to the old school. Ladies... here it is. Rav's going to adorn all of this and go over to the camera runs to keep an eye on all the various crimes and misdemeanors going on in the house. Give him a round of applause.
I don't have to take it off, do I? Yeah.